Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.4 in PERT CPM, the module PERT CPM. The topic for the today's discussion is PERT computation, finding the critical path for the PERT network. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of PERT network. So we take example number 7. The time estimate for a project is given below. Find the critical path, expected project completion time, and the probability that the project will be completed in 30 days. So there are 6 activities: 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 2 to 4, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 3 to 5. The optimistic time are 2, 9, 5, 8, 6, 8. The most likely time are 5, 12, 14, 5, 9, 17. The pessimistic time are 14, 15, 17, 8, 12 and 20. So first we calculate the various parameters: expected time, standard deviation and variance of the activities. So the activities are mentioned here: 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 2 to 4. 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 3 to 5. TO, TM, TP values are given here in the from the problem it is taken. And the expected time, the TE value, which is equal to TO plus 4TM plus TP divided by 6. We calculate for the activities. The values are 6, 12, 13, 5, 9 and 16. The standard deviation, we take the formula sigma equal to TP minus TO divided by 6. So 14 minus 2, 12 divided by 6 equal to 2, 15 minus 9, 6 divided by 6 equal to 1, 17 minus 5, 12 by 6 equal to 2, 8 minus 2, 6 over 6 equal to 1, 12 minus 6, 6 over 6 equal to 1, and 20 minus 8, 12 over 6 equal to 2. And the variance are sigma square, variance equal to sigma square, which is 2 square 4, 1 square 1, 2 square 4, 1 square 1, 1 square 1 and 2 square equal to 4. So these are all the various parameters, various computations of the PERT network. Now we draw the network with all the TE value what we calculated. So 1 to 2, 6 days, 2 to 4, 13 days, 1 to 3, 12 days, 3 to 4, 5 days, 3 to 5, 16 days, and 4 to 5, 9 days. The earliest expected time and the latest allowable time are shown in the network. So this is the network. In the event circle, we have mentioned the event number and the TE value on the left hand side, left bottom, and TL value on the right bottom. We just show the calculation of expected time and the latest allowable time. So in the forward pass computation, we calculate the earliest expected time. So for the first event, we fix TE1 equal to 0. For the second event, there is only one incoming arrow, TE2 equal to TE1 plus TE12 equal to 0 plus 6 equal to 6. For the third event, there is only one incoming arrow, TE3 equal to TE1 plus TE13 equal to 0 plus 12 equal to 12. And TE4, for the 4, there are two events, so two activities entering into the event. So it is maximum of TE3 plus TE34 equal to 12 plus 5 equal to 17. And the TE2 equal to TE2 plus TE24 equal to 6 plus 13 equal to 19. The maximum value is 19. So 19 is the TE value for the fourth event. And for the fifth event, there again there are two incoming arrows. So TE5 equal to maximum of TE35 plus TE3 plus TE35 equal to 12 plus 16 equal to 28. And the TE4 plus TE45 equal to 19 plus 9 equal to 28. So both values are 28. The time is 28 here. Now we use the backward pass computation to calculate the latest allowable time. So TL5, we fix TL5 equal to TE5 equal to 28. TL4 equal to, so for the fourth event there is only one outgoing arrow, TL4 equal to TL5 minus TE45 equal to 28 minus 9 equal to 19. TL3 is minimum of, so TL3 there are two outgoing arrows, minimum of TL5 minus TE35 equal to 28 minus 16 equal to 12. And TL4 minus TE34 equal to 19 minus 5 equal to 14. The minimum value is 12. So for the third event, minimum value is 12. Then TL2 equal to TL4 minus TE24 equal to 19 minus 13 equal to 6, and the TL1, so for the first event, there are two outgoing arrows, minimum of TL3 minus TE13, 12 minus 12 equal to 0, TL2 minus TE12 equal to 6 minus 6 equal to 0, both are 0. Now the slack value we calculate, slack value is the difference between the TE and the TL value, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, here 6 minus 6 equal to 0, for the 4th event 19 minus 19 equal to 0, 3rd event 12 minus 12 equal to 0, and 5th event 28 minus 28 equal to 0. For all the events, the slack value is 0, and the critical events, all the events are critical events, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the events are critical events, and the critical path in the network, there are two critical paths, 1, 2, 4, 5, and 1, 3, 5. These are all the two critical paths. So, 1, 3, 5 and 1, 2, 4, 5. Excepting the activity 3, 4, all the other activities are critical activities. Now, we have to calculate the probability of completing the project work in 30 days. So, to calculate the probability, first we should know the normal deviation. Normal deviation Z equal to TS minus TE divided by sigma, where TS is the contractual obligation time of the network, which is given as 30 days in the network, in the problem. TE is the earliest expected time of the network, which we calculate as 28. Sigma is the square root of sum of variances along the critical path. The normal deviation using the critical path 135, so we calculate Z equal to TS minus TE divided by square root of variance of 13 plus variance of 35, which is equal to 30 minus 28 divided by square root of 1 plus 4 equal to 0.8944. Using the normal distribution table, the probability is 81%. So, the normal distribution table is here in the next slide. For 8944, it is between 0.7881 and 0.8159. So, we take by interpolation, probability is 81%. The normal deviation using the critical path 1245. Z equal to TS minus TE divided by in the critical path 1235, the variances of square root of V of 12, V of plus V of variance of 24 plus variance of 45, which is equal to 30 minus 28 divided by square root of 4 plus 4 plus 1 equal to 0.6669. So using the normal distribution table again, the probability is 75% for the Z value 0.6667. So, 0.6667, so this is 75% and 0.8944 it is 81%. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So, you may find the book Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information on the PERT CPM calculations. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. So, we'll meet again in another video lecture in the PERT computation. Until then, bye-bye.